morning everyone. In last class we finished about different types of which is individual controller modes. We finished the proportional controller mode and we gave introduction about the integral controller mode. So which is integral controller mode is also called as a reset controller. So that equation will be, that is output, controller output is equals to integration of input plus P of 0, where P of 0 is a that controller output with when error comes to 0. So we finished this one. So this is a graph how to draw the integral action whenever the error occurs there. So wherever if error occurs, so the rate of change of output will produced according to the constant error. So here the down one, which is having an error, that is which is like a step signal, so that is which is having a constant error. For that constant error that will produces the rate of change of output that will produces. So here we can derive another term which is a reset time. So this integral controller is also called as a reset controller. Here we are going to talk about the time, that is integral time. In the proportional controller mode, we've taken one parameter, that is proportional band. In the same way, in the integral time, we are going to take the another parameter, that is integral time. So integral time, which is inversely proportional to the integral gain, whatever we take in. So here integral gain is a ki, right? So ki, which is an inverse of the time, that is ti. So we can write that equation as like this, that is ki by s is equals to transfer function or else 1 by t1s. Here ki, so ki is nothing but the integral gain. I already told that integral gain, which is inversely proportional to the time. So we can substitute ki value as 1 by ti. So 1 by ti into s. So this value is, which is a transfer function or transfer function of the integral, integral controller mode. Or we can derive here, the integral gain is equals to the inverse of time, that is 1 by t. Okay. So this is another way of, we can take the another type of error. For that particular error, how that integral action will be taken. So here that above graph which will shows the error signal, according to the error signal here, that will generate the controller output here. So here we have some every block in the process control diagram that will have some, that will show some lag, no? So that we discussed about the control lag, process lag, dead time, these are all. So here we are showing those parameters. So here first that will having a for control lag. After that control lag, in order to process that particular error, that will take time, that will take some time. So that time is called as a process lag. Okay, so according to the error, that rate is also changed. Here, that curve, first curve which represents the error, here in the second curve which represents the integral controller action. Okay, the other name for the integral controller action is reset controller action. This is very important. So next we'll go for the derivative controller mode. So derivative controller mode is also called as rate control mode. So derivative, in the name itself, that till, that is the controller output is proportional to the derivative of the error. Okay, the controller output which is proportional to what? The derivative of the error. So error we can take it as EP, controller output we can take it as P. Okay, nothing but that P is proportional to dEP by dt. Here that is a formula which is P is equals to, or P proportional to dEP by dt. If we remove the proportional symbol here, then what we get? One constant will get. That constant we are calculating the derivative controller mode. So here we can take it that constant as a KD. Okay. KD is a derivative gain. Okay. So here the units for the integral controller, that is integral gain or integral constant, that is 1 by second inverse. That is second inverse or 1 by second is a units for the KI. Here KD is nothing but units are seconds. Seconds are the units for the K. So P is equals to KD dEP by dt. So what is the meaning of this one? Here the output, which is a rate of change of input or rate of change of error. If we can talk like this, we can take it also like this, which is the rate of change of error which will produce is a constant error, constant output. In previous case what? Whenever the constant error is there, that output will produce as a rate of change. Here which is the opposite, the rate of change of error that will produce as the constant output. You can understand by the diagram. Here you observe this is an error diagram, right? So this error diagram, each and every total one, first rate, second rate, third rate and fourth rate, entire the signal which is having four different rates. So for any, for one rate of change of error, that will produce one particular output. Which particular output? That output will be the constant output. Okay, so constant output that will produce according to the rate of change of error here. So from here to here, that will maintain one slope. For this particular slope, that will maintain one type of error. Okay, that will maintain one type of or one type of output, that is a constant output that will produce. And here, this is the second rate that will produce again the constant. So here, what rate is increased, right? So that rate is increased means that error value is increasing. Nothing but that is reaching to the set point. So we need to decrease our controller output. So that rate, that controller output will be decreases. And here again rate will changed. So according to that one, that output value is also changed. Here rate is again changed. According to that one, that output value is also changed. So wherever in the derivative controller mode here, the rate of change of error that will produce is a constant output. Okay, but what is the main disadvantage in the derivative controller mode here? For every rate that will produce is a constant output. So and if there is a rate which is very increasing, for that particular rate that will produce is only one output. Okay, so what is the disadvantage in the proportional mode? In the proportional mode, that will produce is a offset error. Yeah, what is the disadvantage in the integral mode? In the integral mode, that will produce is a curvature which is very faster. Okay, so in order to accumulate, in order to avoid the disadvantages in the individual controller modes, we are going to combine. We are going to combine one or more, that is more than one individual controller modes into one that will maintain the, that will eliminate the disadvantages in the individual controller mode, and that will give effective output. So those are called as a composite controller modes. So composite controller modes, again the combination of any two or more individual controller modes. We have individual controller modes of three. We finished that one, which is a proportional controller mode, integral controller mode and derivative controller mode. So here composite controller mode, which is minimum of two or more than two or more individual controller modes are joined. So first one is the, what is the first one here? Proportional. Second one is integral. So we are combining these two, which is a proportional plus integral. Next, proportional plus derivative. Next, combination of these three, proportional, integral plus derivative. We'll go through this one. So here, before going to that one, this is derivative controller mode, which is here in the integral controller mode, that is that derivative constant, that integral constant, which is inverse of time, right? Here we can define the another time constant, that is derivative time, that is equals to the whatever the integral whatever the derivative constant, that is equals to the derivative action, that is derivative time. Okay, so these are the composite modes, which is a PI control and PID control. So these three, you can see these three in this class. Okay, so next, so before for this derivation, I'm going to give the whiteboard. So I'm sharing the whiteboard now. So here we are going to discuss about the composite controller modes. Okay, so what is mean by composite controller modes? Any combination of two or more individual controller modes. So I am writing that composite controller modes . So first one I am discussing about proportional plus integral, proportional plus integral controller mode. So we already have the proportional equation. So what is the proportional equation here? That proportional equation is P is equals to KP EP plus P naught. So what is the integral equation? That integral equation is P equals to KI integration of ep dt plus p of 0 ki integration of ep dt plus p of 0, where we are combining proportional plus integral, which is a combination of two. Then the controller output equation will become first proportional action, that is kp ep plus ki integration of ep dt plus p of 0, p naught p of 0. So this is our pi equation, kp ep plus ki integration of ep dt plus p of 0, where kp is a proportional gain. So proportional gain, and ki is integral gain. So ki is integral gain, and p of ep is nothing but error. So what is p of 0? This is controller output when error comes to 0, when error comes to 0. So here p of 0, where is there any p naught? No. So we can eliminate the offset error in integral, that is in pi mode. So the main disadvantage of the p mode is that is offset error. Here we are going to eliminate that offset in the pi controller mode. So let us take one example for this one, that error. Okay, so this is, let us take our error is varies like this. So ep, and here let us take time t, and we should draw the output. So let us take initially our integral pi action will start p of 0. Okay, so from here to here, what error is increasing? So error is increasing means that measured value is decreasing here. So measured value is decreasing ante our controller output should be increased. Actually in proportional mode that should be in linear, right? So in the integral mode that should be in somewhat curved. So here we are going to combine these two, so that will produces a curve nature. Okay, so same from here to here, error is decreasing. According to that one, our controller output is also decreases. So in the proportional mode that should be in linear fashion like this. In the integral mode that should be with a curve, and here in the pi mode that should be with having a some curve nature. Okay, so next, same, which in the proportional mode that should be in a linear, in the integral mode that with a curve, and in the pi mode that is with having some more curve. In the same way here error is decreasing, right? So according to that one, controller output should also decreases. And here in the integral mode that should maintain some curve nature, that curve nature will be increased in the pi controller mode like this. Okay, so here red line indicate p plus i, blue line indicate proportional graph, here green light indicate the integral mode. Okay, so like this we can draw the pi controller action. So here we are going to eliminate what the main, that one is a proportional offset, we can eliminate. So next composite mode is, which is proportional plus derivative controller mode. Proportional plus derivative controller mode. So what is proportional plus derivative controller mode? Which is here, derivative controller mode is very faster. Okay, sudden actions will be taken here. So sudden actions. But sudden actions, if there is any sudden actions, that process will damage. That process may damage. So we are going to combine those sudden actions or sudden change in the derivative controller mode and next whatever the linear action, we are going to combine these two in the proportional and derivative controller mode. So what is the proportional equation? We already know that P is equals to Kp Ep plus P naught. What is the derivative controller output equation? That is P is equals to Kd into dEp by dt. Okay, so here if we combine these two, we'll get P is equals to Kp Ep plus Kp Kd dEp by dt plus P naught. Okay, so this is the final equation for proportional plus derivative controller mode. In previous equation also we have here one term, which is here KpKi, KpKi dEp integration of Ep dt. So this is same here KpEp. So KpEp, Kp is a what? Which is a proportional constant. Ep is a error. Kd is a derivative constant. And here P naught. What about P naught here? That is offset error. So offset error is not eliminated in the PD mode. Eliminated in PD mode. So for example, if we take one error signal, which is like this. So you should draw the controller output for that one. This is EP and let us take this as P. Okay, so here controller output should produce a linear action and sudden change. Here we have, which is some rate of change of error is there. So in the integral action, so that will first in a first let us start that at P naught that will start, let us take. So that sudden change is there, sudden change, and then that will perform the linear action. So here we are having another rate, so that rate will be decreases. So sudden change is there and that will be maintain the linear action. And again that rate is increased or decreased according to that one, that sudden change is there and that value will be increased. So here this will shows our derivative action and this will shows our proportional action. So like this we can take the proportional plus derivative. Okay, so next we'll go for, which is a very important in all industries, we are going for this type of composite mode, which is proportional plus integral plus derivative. So here the main advantage of this PID mode is, in this we are going to eliminate the offset error and we are going to get the sudden change of error to the sudden change of error, that sudden change of controller output that can produce as well as, and here that will produce is the curve nature. So we already know that P value, P controller output is Kp Ep plus P naught, that is offset. In integral, P equals to Ki integration of Ep dt plus P of 0, that is error comes to 0. P that in the derivative action, that is Kd into dEp by dt. So we are going to combine these all equations here. First Kp Ep, next one here Ki integration of Ep dt plus Kd into dEp by dt plus P of 0. So here we are going to get the another constant. That is here we are going to get the another constant, that is here Kp we can write, and here Kp Kd. So this is a final equation of your PID mode. Just all terms are having the Kp values. Okay, so shall we take the example for this one? Yes. So let us take, this is an error signal. Same example I am going to take. This is an error signal. So here, for that error signal, that should produce as the controller output. So this is T. And here this is EP, let us take. And this is P. Okay. So here that should write that this, according to the error, that should produce as the controller output in the composite mode, that is P plus I plus D. Okay, so first here let us take the initial value is P of 0 that started. Due to the derivative action, some sudden changes there. Actually that due to the proportional action, that should be linear. That should be linear. But here we are adding the integral also. So that will produce some curvature. And again here some another rate is there. So sudden change, and that will produce some curve, and again that will have the sudden change, so some rate, and again that will produce some linear. So this curve will indicate P plus I plus D. So here sudden change, that will indicate the derivative action. So this is about the composite modes of total controller modes, which is proportional integral, proportional derivative, and proportional integral plus derivative. So by this year, first part in your second chapter is over. So in the next class we'll see about the different electronic controllers, what are the different types of controllers are there, and we'll discuss about the electronic controllers in the next class. Thank you.